Hey everybody, how's it going?
Today, let's take a detailed look at the 2002 Chrysler Sebring Limited Convertible. And this is going to be an in-depth tour of the Sebring. We'll start up, show the engine, get an exhaust clip and go over the performance data, and show you a few of the aspects of the interior as well as exterior.
And I'd like to give a big thanks and special shout out to Brandon Reeves Auto World, located in Monroe, North Carolina, for allowing me to come out and film this 2002 Chrysler Sebring Convertible.
And so, without further ado, let's go ahead and start her up, let her run.
The exterior color is in those deep sapphire blue pearl coat with a matching blue convertible top, paired with a full cream leather interior and deep royal blue accenting on the dash, doors, and the carpet. Has around 117,000 miles. Now the Sebring Limited came standard with the unique white-faced, almost retro touch gauge pack that you also find in the Chrysler 300M and some of the upper trim levels of the other LH platform cars, and nicely accented with a little bit of chrome bright work surrounding the pods. The steering is simple, power rack and pinion, wrapped in full leather, also part of the Limited package. As far as the gearbox, standard transmission was a 4-speed automatic with the auto stick manual shiftability down below. In some of the sportier models, such as the GTC, you can also opt for a 5-speed manual transmission. And before we begin, we'll go ahead and put the top down. Just release the clamps on either side. And then hit the button mounted in the center console. Top flips back quickly. So we got flip on the headlamps, fog lamps, as well as the hazards. The driver's side window is automatic down, and we'll go ahead and check out the exterior, shall we?
The Chrysler Sebring lineup received a refresh in the 2001 model year that not only improved the build quality, but the ride, handling, as well as vibration control. Still kept the overall design platform. Simple, elegant front end. And standard halogen headlamps. Large prominent egg crate grille highlighted by some modest chrome.
The Sebring redesign also gave the convertible a little bit more of a streamlined, sleeker look. A little bit of chrome embedded in the door side molding of the Limited trim. And it also came standard with 17-inch chrome-clad aluminum alloy wheels, wrapped in all-season tires, and paired with four-wheel disc brakes and anti-lock brakes.
And also one of the main reasons I wanted to do this particular tour is I've always enjoyed this color combination of this generation Sebring.
It kind of reminded me of the Chrysler 300M convertible that I desperately wanted somebody to make back in the day when I used to have one. High gloss black surrounds coming around the convertible top, opening up into that very light color interior. Definitely gave the appearance of being looking like a lot higher quality than the price point actually showed. Wrap around tail lamps. A little bit of chrome surrounding the license plate housing. And a chrome accent exhaust tip. Overall length is 193.7 inches with a width of 69.4 inches and a height of around 55 inches. Total curb weight is right around 3,491 pounds. Go ahead and pop the hood. Now while standard Sebrings came with a 2.4 liter 150 horsepower 4-cylinder, this particular one has the optional 2.7 liter dual overhead cam 24 valve V6. The V6 puts out 200 horsepower at 5,800 RPM and 190 pound-feet of torque at 4,850 RPM. And with a 16-gallon fuel tank running on regular unleaded gas, expect to get miles to a gallon rating of somewhere around 17 city, 24 highway. Now during this era of Chrysler products, they shared a lot of parts with Mitsubishi. Really only the coupe counterpart carried a lot of parts in the Mitsubishi Eclipse, including a lot of the interior styling. You notice on the convertible and sedan counterparts, they're pretty much standard Mopar design. Now as far as interior styling for the day, in my opinion, is pretty elegant. You have some faux wood accenting, modest badging, and little subtle amounts of chrome trim and unique color combination like we talked about earlier. Build quality is pretty decent. It's not like a Toyota or anything like that from the day, but there is a nice amount of soft touch material coming across the doors, including some lower parts of the storage compartment. All of your power windows are located on the door. Your modest Chrysler badging. And your power locks are located next to your door handle. Power mirrors are located to the left-hand side of the steering column. The seats themselves are power sliding and tilting with power height adjustment and manual recline, and feature a good amount of comfort, reasonable support with little side bolstering coming across, and a good amount of padding where it matters the most. Logo door entry guards, logo limited floor mats, power trunk release located down below, and manual tilting steering wheel. The dash is also covered in a soft touch material. So let's go ahead and see how she sounds. There is a rev limiter in park and neutral around 4,000 RPM. Put the top back up. and roll the windows back up. Now the standard Chrysler radio has been replaced with a Pioneer aftermarket deck with an in-dash CD player, MP3 compatible, Bluetooth compatible with USB input, pretty much a standard modern audio system. I believe in some of the Sebrings, maybe not in 2002, but some of the later years, you can also get the Infinity audio system, and even a navigation system I believe could go in place of the standard head unit. But the standard audio system's not bad at all. Garage home link. Auto-dimmy rearview mirror. Overall, interior styling and functionality is very simple and easy to figure out. There's a little digital driver information system up there with your fuel data, trip computer, and outside temperature. English to metric. Simple to use climate control system. Your fan speed. Temperature. Different zones. Front defrost and rear defrost. Factory 4 disc CD changer. 12 volt power outlet. 2 cup holders. Heated seats for the driver and passenger. And a leather armrest with a little bit of storage and another 12 volt power outlet. Intermittent wipers, landing control, and your cruise control located on each side of the wheel. But that's pretty much it. And we'll go ahead and shut her down. So let's check out the back seat. While you could use the recline to fold down the back seat, this is the proper button here and flips it all the way up. Back seat room is also pretty reasonable. I'm 5'11", and with a normal driving position, my knees are just barely touching. There might be a little bit of half an inch or so of space. Headroom, maybe an inch and a half, 2 inches. You have 2 cup holders in the back with a little bit of lighting. There's your manual lumbar for the driver's seat. And we're going to check out the rest of the vehicle, shall we? As far as trunk space, it's around 11.3 cubic feet. Not too bad, especially for a convertible. The passenger seat is fully manual. Automatically slides forward, unlike the driver's seat, but that's because that one's powered. Reasonable glove box. The Sebring lineup had a lot of different models. There was even a base model LX for the convertible if you didn't want to step it on up to this one, and came with that 150 horsepower 4-cylinder. You can usually pick them up pretty cheap these days. They had reasonable build quality and definitely some nice styling for the day to make it a pretty good drop top for everyday occasions. Well everyone, I hope you enjoyed this detailed look at the 2002 Chrysler Sebring Limited Convertible. Be sure to stay tuned next time. There's a lot more where that came from. Take care, everybody.